we're following some breaking news in West Sacramento. The Athletics will be playing at Sutter Health Park next season. You were looking live right there. We're minutes away from a press conference to officially announce this deal. And again, there's a live look at the podium as you see members of the press and members of the organizations all taking their seats as we are expecting, again, this press conference to begin any moment now. Of course, let's take a quick look at how we actually got here. The Oakland Athletics have been looking to move from the Coliseum for years, working to build a waterfront property in Oakland. But after years of discussions with that city, the plan never moved forward. The Athletics decided to move to the Las Vegas Strip. That's a move that was approved by Major League Baseball just last November. But as you can imagine, it's going to take some time to build that new stadium. You're looking at a rendering right there. Their lease with Oakland was ending after this season. And that brings us to today. The Athletics coming to a deal to play three seasons at the home of the Rivercats with an option to play in 2028 until their Las Vegas stadium is built. And of course, we have team coverage there at Sutter Health Park. Let's check in now with Melanie Wingle and Michelle Dapper, who's live at the press conference. Lots of buzz, lots of excitement, ladies.
Absolutely, Mike. It is incredible here to see just who's who at the location here at Sutter Health Park. Dapper and I were just talking about the fact that pretty much all the major players in sports and community development here now at Sutter Health Park waiting for this announcement to be announced.
Yeah, absolutely. We just saw Vivek Ranadive walk in here, and of course John Fisher's here. It's happening. It's official. The A's are coming to Sacramento, and we're moments away from the announcement. And again, a bittersweet day for A's fans, but an exciting day for the city of Sacramento.
Yeah,
West Sacramento. Let me emphasize that as well.
It's almost like one of those things where you'll probably remember where you were when you heard the announcement.
Sleeping in bed,
your morning.
And waking up and checking my morning emails. That's where I was.
Did the announcement shock you?
No, not at all. Not at all. We've been expecting this. I mean, this goes back to like 5 years ago. The city of Sacramento, we knew the A's were going to be looking for a home. Was Sacramento in play? Maybe not until the past, a few months, whatnot. But they needed a home before they moved to Las Vegas. And there was several options on the table with Salt Lake, staying in Oakland. They couldn't come to terms with that deal. So Sacramento stepped in. And, hey, this is a great opportunity for Sacramento to audition for a Major League Baseball team. A lot of eyes are going to be on this city now. Can they fill the seats? Time will tell there. Are A's fans going to show up? We don't know. Are they going to support this ownership? We don't know. But another thing, too, is how this ballpark is going to share both teams. They got natural grass on the field. You got the Rivercats playing, as well as the Athletics. Can the grass hold up for both teams to play throughout the summer next year? So it's going to be a lot of questions. But again, don't want to take away from the excitement that's happening here in West Sacramento.
Yeah, and that excitement building here at Sutter Health Park, as we mentioned, a news conference about to get underway. And just in the last 10 minutes or so, we've seen just this influx of, as you mentioned, Mike, at the top of this hour, members of the organization, also people from the city of West Sacramento, the greater Sacramento region, coming together for this announcement to be made. And it is a cold, bitter cold morning here at Sutter Health Park, but such an announcement that will warm the hearts of fans. Yeah. Because the A's are going to be so close. Can you talk about the fact that in advance of this news conference starting, and we will of course break away as soon as it does start, can you talk about the nature of the deal? Okay, we're talking about three seasons for sure
with an option of a fourth. We know how, of course, stadium processes work. I feel like it's getting quiet, so I think we might be starting the press conference.
Yeah, there is a hush that has fallen over the audience.
So we're just going to pick it up with the press conference.
Okay, we'll send it back to you in the studio to listen in.
All right, thank you so much, Melanie and Michelle Dapper. And indeed, let's take a look and listen in. It looks like they are receiving a message right now from Representative Doris Matsui right now, speaking to the audience as we see right there. But as we continue to wait, or should we listen in? All right, let's listen in.
To baseball fans across the globe, I want to commend the collaborative efforts of Vivek Ranadive and John Fisher for bringing Major League Baseball to our community. And thank you to Mayor Guerrero and Barry Broom for your leadership. This partnership not only highlights the strength and resilience of Greater Sacramento, but also represents a significant opportunity for our region to come together and celebrate America's favorite pastime. From job creation to increased tourism, this partnership will positively impact our local economy and provide new opportunities for growth and prosperity. And I would also like to extend a warm welcome to all A's fans. I'm excited to see the energy you bring to Sutter Health Park. And now, I'd like to introduce the owner and chairman of the Sacramento Kings, Vivek Ranadive.
I don't know how many of you met Doris, but she's like the biggest, littlest person in Congress. She's amazing. So thank you. Thank you, Congresswoman Matsui. I'm just so excited. I can hardly contain myself. Can you guys hear me?
Yeah.
Sorry. So this is incredibly exciting. This is like having lower bowl seats at a basketball game. Like, every seat is amazing. And John, we're going to be sitting here. I don't know if Gavin's going to throw out the first pitch or you're going to throw it out, or who's going to throw it out.
You are.
I am.
Yeah.
I am. That's a deal. That's a promise. I'm in. And just imagine, you're going to have lower bowl seats. You're going to have Geloff at second base. You're going to see Otani. You're going to see Aaron Judge hitting home runs out there. This is what an incredible day. This is epic. It's historic. We're really grateful for Doris's partnership and her family's service to the state. So thank you. Thank you, Doris. And it's a huge privilege to be here alongside my friend John, Barry, Mayor Guerrero. John, thank you for this opportunity to be part of the A's legacy and show the world why Sacramento is a destination city for Major League sports. I also want to thank MLB Commissioner Rob Manfred. It's an honor for West Sacramento to host Major League Baseball at Sutter Hill Park. We're committed to providing A's players and fans with a world-class baseball experience at Sutter Health, while also continuing the beloved tradition of minor league baseball and the Sacramento River Cats. When I bought the Kings over 10 years ago, I said that Sacramento would never play second fiddle to any other city in the world. And the success of Golden One Center has proven that this region can be a mecca for sports. We have an incredible community and a passionate fan base, the best fans in the world. Today's announcement marks the next chapter of professional sports in Sacramento. We have a tremendous opportunity to showcase everything the region has to offer and demonstrate why it is deserving of an MLB game. This is an exciting time to be a sports fan in Sacramento, and I know the community will welcome the A's here with open arms. And now, this is the win, right? John, we're making this challenging on you. Is that better?
They turned it on. We turned it on. It's turned on.
It's on? Okay, so John, it's going to be a little easier on you. So, I want to welcome my friend John Fisher. John?
Oh, the wind calmed down just as I got up here. I just want to say how excited I am to be here in West Sacramento in Sutter Health Park. Celebrating a momentous day for this community and a momentous day for our 123-year-old franchise. I want to extend my thanks to Vivek, who's not only a good friend, but a great business person, great associate, and for helping make this day possible. To you and your team at the Kings, and at the Rivercats, you know, working with you guys has been a dream for our guys as well. I want to thank Mayor Guerrero, who and the whole West Sacramento community for being so welcoming to us. And I just want to say we're excited to be here for the next 3 years, playing in this beautiful ballpark, but also being able to watch some of the greatest players in baseball, whether they be athletics players or Aaron Judge and others, launch home runs out of this very intimate, the most intimate ballpark in all of Major League Baseball for the next 3 years. And we're looking forward to this being our home until we move on to our stadium in Las Vegas in 2028. So thank you, everybody, for all your hospitality, for being so welcoming. And now I'd like to pass this on to Barry Byrne.
Thank you, John. Well, in our organization, we use these terms, money, power, deals, you know, because we put our heads down and we really work hard to do big things for our community. So, you know, I want to thank Vivek. I told Vivek, you kind of saved us twice. You know, he kept the Kings here. And, you know, the narrative of California and our communities are getting a little roughed up. And the narrative in our region, our community, is we're on the rise. I want to thank John Reinhart for his help. I also want to thank my boss, Matina Kovacs-Petronas, the chairman of the board of the Greater Sacramento Valley Council, the highest ranking female executive in the NBA. You know, when you put women in charge, like, stuff just starts working. I don't know. I just need a few more years, so just hang on to that for a while. But what I love best about this is, you know, in order to change your own community's future, we've had to change how we think and see ourselves. And we've struggled to see ourselves reaching our full potential. And I really think this is, you know, there's a saying when you're working together in a community and you want it to be its most inspired state. How do you get your community on the map? We're on the map today. We're on the map. Thank you, John. Thank you, Sandy, for taking 1,200 phone calls and always being nice. I want to thank Angelique Ashby, our state senator, standing up here today. Right there. We need a counterpuncher in the state capitol. We got one. And we got a state senator that stands up for us. No more elected officials worrying about what they're doing next and what their future looks like. We need elected officials to worry about our future as a community. You can always count on Senator Ashby to be one. So thank you. So we know the impact, right? You know, we have an entire multi-month built-in media marketing campaign called the A's. I think this is going to be the most fun stadium to watch a game in Major League Baseball. You know, and one of the other things that's really important is, you know, we're so thrilled today, but we're not satisfied, because in 2028, there'll be more teams to compete for, and we want to be a permanent Major League Baseball franchise. And as long as the A's get the support they deserve, we might have a guy on the inside over there putting in a good word for the Sacramento community. So I'm super grateful. It's an exciting day. I want to thank my team that's in the back, a bunch of young Tigers that fight every day for us. And it's my pleasure to introduce the mayor of West Sacramento, Mayor Guerrero. Mayor, thank you.
Thank you, Barry. And thank you, everybody, for being here today to join us in this historic celebration of Major League Baseball here in Sutter Health Park. Thank you, Vivek and John, for making this happen, for your leadership. West Sacramento loves you, loves your Major League Baseball here. We're going to make this beautiful, intimate place a welcoming, embracing environment for you. We are so excited for this historic day because it's been a dream of West Sacramento to have a Major League team here. And when Vivek came here to get the Rivercats, I felt that power, that passion. I saw that this man is going to make things happen and bring West Sacramento on the map. Thank you so much. Thank you. And John, hard work running a team. I've seen it happen. And you know what? We're so excited to have you here and making this a reality for us. We embrace you. All of West Sacramento is going to thrive because of your presence. And so thank you for also the leadership. Grateful for all you've done and making this happen. We know it's a team effort here, and also our city council members are here, and Yolo County supervisors are out there. Wave your hands. Thank you so much for being here and joining us in this celebration. This is going to bring an economic prosperity here for all of our restaurants, Franquette's, The Barn, down the street down to Midway Grill, and also Sal's, and other restaurants that are up and down the beautiful riverfront. It's going to be a place where you can stay, eat, ride your bike here, and just come in every which way you can. We have everything in place. We've been waiting for this moment. We've been building the riverfront for this moment, and we are ready to make this happen and make it as successful, as Barry said, more than the 3 years. So we are here with you, making it happen. So thank you so much, everyone. Excited to have you here joining us in this celebration. And let's play ball in the future here.
All right, you just listened in as representatives and officials just made it official right there. The A's are going to be coming to West Sacramento. They're going to be making Sutter Health Park their home for the next 3 years. See, this is much a right here a photo opportunity. Earlier, we heard Representative Doris Matsui, who later introduced Vivek Ranadive, owner of Sutter Health Park and the Kings, who then also introduced John Fisher, of course, the owner of the Athletics. And you just heard from West Sacramento Mayor Martha Guerrero. She even joked that they hope to have the Athletics around for the next 3 years. We do have team coverage on this. We have our very own Melanie Wingo and Michelle Dapper out there at this press conference. And Melanie, let's start with you. Why don't you just take it away? I know you just got to hear exactly the same things that we heard play out as this press conference wraps up.
Yeah, Mike, and forgive me, our audio is a little bit touch and go, so if I miss a question, just repeat it, but things are wrapping up, as you mentioned, after this news conference. A bit brief, but definitely powerful in what this means for the greater Sacramento area. Michelle Dapper is here. I want to just check in with you a bit because we know you have to go do some interviews one-on-one with the key players here. What are your thoughts after this major announcement?
Well, again, exciting news for Sacramento. Going to be great for the economy here, and again, you're going to see some world-class baseball being played. You might look, Linden native Aaron Judge hitting bombs. You can see Shohei Ohtani out here playing. So it's going to be a very intimate setting for some baseball.
They talked about this being that intimate setting, like the front row seats, the close-up seats for such a national stage. Yep. It's incredible.
It's incredible. We got the Oakland A's. Excuse me, no longer the Oakland A's. The Athletics. That's going to be weird to get used to. Yeah. But the Athletics are going to be playing here. So, yeah, you're going to have some great baseball coming to be played here at Sutter Health Park. And you know, West Sacramento is taking this as an opportunity to maybe audition for a Major League Baseball team, and perhaps if expansion ever does come about within the league.
And before you go, I want to know, what do you want to ask the people who are here today making these big announcements? What would you like to ask Vivek Ranadive and, the owner of the A's this morning?
What's the long-term goal here? What do you hope to accomplish during these 3 years while this team is here? What do you hope to showcase about our city? And, what's next for Sacramento and West Sacramento? That's what I want to know.
All right. right. You heard it here. We'll get let you get those answers, Michelle. And just again, recapping here, we're also, I'm seeing that the mayor of West Sacramento is out here, and she made a rousing speech as well, talking about what this means from an economic standpoint for West Sacramento and the greater Sacramento region. We also heard CEO of the Greater Sacramento Economic Council, Barry Broom, talking about just what an impact this will make on the city of Sacramento, the greater Sacramento region. I'm looking around along with you because I'd love to walk up and get some close-up reaction with some of these key players after the announcement was made today that the A's are coming to play at Sutter Health Park. As was mentioned, this is a three-season deal with an option for a fourth season here at Sutter Health Park. And I should mention also, speaking in terms of the economic impact for the community, it spreads beyond the city of Sacramento. For the city of West Sacramento, this is going to mean huge things. The mayor of West Sacramento talking about how it will help local restaurants, local businesses, and of course, the community at large. Oh, I see the mayor. One second. I'm going to run right over to Mayor Martha Guerrero, and I'm going to steal her right here. Hey, Mayor Melanie with KCRA. Hey, glad we're here. We do know that you have to go. You're a woman in high demand. So happy to see you this morning, Martha Guerrero, Mayor of West Sacramento. Your speech this morning, so much energy, so much excitement. Talk about your feelings this morning.
We are just so excited. It's a historic day. West Sacramento has been dreaming of a major league team, and having the A's here play, we are going to embrace you, A's, and your fans are going to have a great time in this beautiful ballpark. It's going to be an intimate setting where you're going to see all the other teams come in here. So we're excited about that. We've been dreaming about this, and it's just a historic day for West Sacramento.
And quickly, one more question while we're live on air. I do want to ask you, what went into making this deal a reality for the city of West Sacramento and the greater Sacramento region?
It is the leadership of Vivek and John that they've made it happen. And that leadership is incredible. That friendship they have is just, you know, as you heard, goes back a ways. And so that leadership in us as a partner saying, we are here to support you to make it happen.
Okay, and how are you going to make it happen with a Major League Baseball team and, of course, the River Cats? We can't forget the home team here, too.
Well, those are details that the team owners work on, and we'll do what we can to support that here, and we're going to make it happen. We're going to make it work.
Okay, and the infrastructure, we'll get the infrastructure all up to snuff to accommodate the influx.
That's right. We had our police and fire chief here because we all work together as a team to make this a reality and make it work for everybody. For all the fans, enjoy the riverfront, enjoy our beautiful Sutter Health Park, and also just come and take a look at the team close up front in such an intimate ballpark.
All right. Thank you. Martha Guerrero, Mayor of West Sacramento, giving her thoughts on this major announcement today. We'll also walk around just a little bit. I'm going to have my photographer, Brandon, walk around this way and just give you the scope of this announcement. This is such a huge deal for our community and greater Sacramento as a whole. You can see how many people are here today. Lots of people from local leaders, economic leaders, sports leaders, and figureheads out here today. As Michelle Dapper was talking a bit earlier, this is such a major announcement because not only does it bring baseball to our community, which is a huge deal in and of itself, but it also brings Major League Baseball teams from across the country to the greater Sacramento area, plus all their fans and their dollars as well when they come to watch their teams play here in such an intimate setting as we talked about here at Sutter Health Park. So, Mike, I don't know what your thoughts are back in the studio. It feels like an electric environment out here, despite the fact that it's pouring rain now outside.
Yeah, no.
And it has been quite a cold morning.
Look at you. You're doing breaking news and you're providing a weather report, Melanie. That's a team player right there.
Hey, we do what we can.
Real quick, I know that you haven't been there at the park too long this morning, but have you been able to see whether or not there might have been any fans around? Have you been able to speak to anybody? Just maybe capturing the buzz that they might be feeling.
You know, Mike, when we first pulled up, it was just members of the media here out in front of the park, and then we pretty readily came inside and got credentialed and admitted to the area where they are having a news conference. So we didn't have a chance to get fan reaction, but I can tell you that it appears that members of, say, the business office from the River Cats, they're here. Of course, a very celebratory environment with those folks lining up and watching the announcement unfold right in their office, so to speak. I'm going to see if we can put our microphone in here as Barry Broom with the Greater Sacramento Economic Council is speaking, and he is talking about this announcement as well. Let's listen in for just a minute.
Well, the Bridge District is going to take off. So this whole area is called the Bridge District. There's plans on putting a $1 billion life science investment here, top-end housing, hotels. So West Sacramento, shout out to West Sacramento, the little engine that could put its head down. You know, people used to call it an old railroad town. You know, they got a little chip on their shoulder in West Sacramento, and today is a great day for the region. But how about a shout out to West Sacramento? And the Bridge District and the Drake and the Barn and this whole corridor is going to get hot.
Thank you so much, Mr. Broom.
Hey, Barry, quick question. KCRA here. Just wanted to see if you could talk with us briefly about the economic impact for the Greater Sacramento area. And as you mentioned, that little engine that could, West Sacramento.
Yeah, I mean, you know, we estimate this will be about a $650 million a year economic impact. So to give you the magnitude of that, you know, that's almost the economic impact of a university. I think the second important impact is, you know, the story that's going to be told here is these people in Sacramento love baseball. And, you know, I know there'll never be an empty seat in this stadium. And I think the statement's going to be that, you know, we're moving up. We're on the rise. I always ask the question, why aren't you here? Right? This is the top market in California now. We're going to outpace California. We're going to outpace the United States of America. This is one of the most dynamic economies in the United States right now, according to the Brookings Institute.
And how did you get this deal done? We know you had a seat at this table. Describe the process for making this a reality.
You know, people, you know, we're double the market size of Las Vegas. So we use data. So right now there are six Major League Baseball cities in the United States whose economy and media position is dramatically smaller than ours. But, you know, because we're the little redheaded stepchild of San Francisco and San Diego and L.A., you know, people just don't look at us. And they're going to look at us now. They're going to start putting eyeballs on our community that they haven't had in the past. Because we've had the Kings since 85, and that's kind of looked at a legacy play. But now, you know, in modern competition, you know who we beat? We beat Salt Lake. Salt Lake's got a Major League Soccer team. You know, and so, you know, that's a community on the rise. So we've proven we've got more to offer a second Major League sports town than any town in America. And if I'm Major League Baseball or Major League Soccer, I'm putting a franchise here as soon as possible.
Sounds like lots more groundwork is being laid for the future of sports in Sacramento. Thank you for your time this morning. So that's a sense of what's happening here at Sutter Health Park. Still many more thoughts to be shared on all of this. We know Michelle Dapper is on top of it, getting some interviews right now as we speak with the key players in this deal. Mike, I'll send it back to you now, and we'll continue to try to reach out to some of those fans who might be outside.
Melanie, thank you so much. Great job, you and Michelle. We really appreciate your live reporting this morning. And again, as it was just confirmed, the Athletics are coming to West Sacramento. They'll be playing at Sutter Health Park. That starts in 2025. They have a three-year contract with the option to potentially extend this into 2028, depending on where things are at in terms of construction for their stadium in Las Vegas. A couple of things that we still don't know. We know that they're going to be called the Athletics. Will they be attaching a city to the front of their name? That's still not 100% just yet. And there's been a lot of talk about the seating capacity for Sutter Health Park. We do know that currently there are more than 10,600 permanent seats right now at SHP. With when you include lawn seating, that can get up to about 14,000. And of course, a lot of folks are wondering, well, are they going to be able to add seating? That's another thing that we're still trying to figure out. But Sutter Health Park did release in a statement saying that they are going to be working with MLB to meet MLB standards, and that includes creating a new clubhouse and adding other additions. Of course, we're going to continue to follow this breaking news throughout the day, so stay tuned to KCRA 3 News online, on air. We're now going to return you to your regular programming.